And welcome back to another video. And today I have a super exciting GFX video for you guys. So today, as you could tell by the thumbnail and the title of this video, I am going to be doing a sort of like a jewelry shop theme GFX, I guess. So it's going to be pretty much just a jewelry shop. As you can see in the thumbnail, you guys can see the GFX, but be sure to stay tuned till the end so you can see the final product because it is super cute. So I decided to model my own ring and diamonds. This GFX was actually heavily inspired by a diamond tutorial I saw for Blender. So I decided to model my own ring and diamonds and everything like that, and then just kind of made that the center part of the GFX and had my character looking in. So I really hope you guys enjoy. So right now I am just modeling the ring, and I am also of course modeling the diamond, and it's going a little bit slow because of course I'm watching a tutorial while doing it, because really without this tutorial I could not make this diamond, especially not as pretty as it looks, because really the tutorial worked so well. If you guys want to check it out, it's on YouTube. You can just look up like Blender 2.8 diamond tutorial. It just comes right up, so you'll be able to see it super easily, and it actually makes a very pretty GFX. So I was thinking maybe if you guys like this GFX, I could do like a recreation tutorial on it, because I thought it'd be super fun to put your own character in and stuff, and maybe like model your own ring. So if you want to see that, let me know down in the comments below, because I of course always make videos based on your guys' feedback. So if that is something you guys want to see, just let me know. Right now, just setting up the texture, or I guess it's called the material in Blender. So the material for the diamond, and they had me put in like red, green, and blue for RGB, and it has to do something with like lighting and refraction, I believe. So that's why the nodes look all crazy, but yeah, so I'm not very good at that kind of stuff, honestly, but in the diamond tutorial video, he explains all of it and why the nodes are the way they are, and in the end, they came out super beautiful and super realistic looking. So like I keep saying, be sure to stay tuned till the end, because I think you guys will love the finished product. Also, speaking of GFX recreation tutorials, it's a little bit off topic, but I was thinking about doing a recreation tutorial for my roller coaster GFX. So let me know down in the comments if that's something you guys would like to see, because I know a lot of people have been like kind of recreating my roller coaster GFX, like not like stealing the idea or anything, but just like kind of recreating it and crediting me for inspiration. So that's how I see them. So if that's something you guys would like to see, like an exact recreation tutorial for that GFX, let me know, because I really want to make more tutorials like that, because I feel like they're like more helpful than some of my other ones, where like they're not more helpful, but I feel like they're kind of more popular, where you can learn how to make a specific GFX. So let me know if that's something you guys would like to see. Right now I am just setting up a like jewelry case, so she's gonna be looking in like through glass, because you know, like the special like jewels and stuff, like necklaces and rings and things and bracelets are all kind of protected behind glass. So that's kind of the effect I am going for. And I'm sorry if the footage is kind of choppy if you guys are watching how I do it. Pretty much what I did for the glass is I just like used a glass BSDF, I believe. And that's pretty much it for that. The footage is choppy because my Blender kept crashing repeatedly when I was recording this video. It was really frustrating. Thankfully, we got it figured out, so that's no longer a problem. Now I am also testing out a different sort of material or texture idea for the table. I wanted to make it like a red velvet or satin sort of texture, so it looked like very fancy, but unfortunately I couldn't really do that. Surprisingly, online there's not a lot of tutorials for making like a velvet material in Blender, so if you guys have any ideas for that, or If you guys know how to make it, just let me know down in the comments below, because I love chatting with you guys. All right, right now I am just setting up the scene a little bit more, so I am putting in some little diamonds on the sides. I know that's not really realistic for like a jewelry case to have just diamonds laying everywhere, but I thought it made it look like super, I guess, fancy, like exclusive. Like there's just like little diamonds sprinkled everywhere, and then the really pretty ring. And now I am just making my character, trying to make her pose like kind of leaning against the glass and tilting her head a little bit, so she looks like really intrigued by this ring on the inside. And I also tried to go for a little bit of a downwards angle, like from the table looking up. I thought that would look really pretty instead of just like looking from the outside. So a tip for your guys is GFX if you want it, though I know sometimes like angles can be a little bit of a problem. Not a problem, of course, because I think all GFX look really good. But just like sometimes a way to make your GFX look a lot better is just to use different angles. So instead of just looking like straight on, like just looking straight at the character, you can make it like from the ground, up from the sky. It makes it honestly look really, really good. But yeah, so that's just like a little tip I have if you guys ever want to try it, because I really think it makes your GFX look like really, really, really good. It gives them kind of an interesting perspective. And right now, at least recently, I've been super, super addicted to just making all my GFX like from an angle looking from the ground. So that's been my thing recently. But right now I am just adding in some different lighting. I added in some bright lighting on the inside with the ring, so it would be super pretty and kind of look like it's like shining onto the ring. And then I also added some store lighting and some pink lighting on my character as well. So it is rendering right now, and I will also be denoising this with the denoiser node. If you guys want to learn about that, I talk all about that in my lighting tutorial video. I'll have that linked in the info card, or if I do not, you can just find it on my channel. Sometimes I forget to link videos, so that's not good, but you know, it's on my channel. If you just look up Pickle Pie lighting tutorial, it'll come right up. So right now I am just doing a little bit of editing. I really didn't do a whole lot of editing with this GFX. I added in some sparkles on the ring to make it look very sparkly, and then just added in some different colors and things to make it look super cute. So pretty much just testing out a whole lot of different filters. And I am also going to be adding in a little bit of blush on my character. As you can see, I probably tested out like 500 different filters before I finally chose the one that I wanted. Oh, and also putting my watermark on there. I'm getting a lot better at putting my watermark on GFX now, because in the past, I would never put my watermark on things, and when I had to like send them to people, I would always have to go back and watermark them, which was not good. So finally, I have started actually watermarking all my GFX. Just so, you know, if people want to know who made it, they know who, you know, and just to help with no one stealing it. Now I am also putting, like, how do you pronounce it? It's the one with the little circles. It's like a bouquet. It's one of those. And just adding a little bit of shading on my character to give it a little bit more depth. And now I believe I will also be adding in the blush I was talking about, and I kind of made myself look like a clown, but that's okay because I blurred it out and made it look super cute. And pretty much other than that, I think that is it for this GFX. I think it is super cute, and I really hope you guys like it. So here is the finished product. I hope you guys like it. I think it is actually so gorgeous. I'm really proud of it, but let me know down in the comments what you guys think, and let me know if you would do anything differently. Of course, still let me know if you would like to see a recreation tutorial for this GFX, because I would absolutely love to make one of those if you are interested in seeing it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I haven't really made a GFX video in a long, long time. I have been kind of overloaded with orders lately, and I am so thankful for you guys all taking the time to order GFX for me. I really appreciate it so much, but last night I just took a little bit of time to sit down and make a GFX for myself, and I think it turned out so, so beautiful, so I really hope you guys like it. If you want to see the full quality version, I will probably have it on my Discord server, so make sure to go down to the description if you have Discord and join my server. I am active there every day, so I would really appreciate it if you come and join and hang out with us. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up, and also if you are new, please be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you do not miss any future notifications for my channel. But anyways guys, that is all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching, I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye guys!